स्पीड ऑफ ए लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल वेव, लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल वेव. एंड हियर आई एम टेकिंग द साउंड वेव, साउंड वेव. एज आई सेड दैट mechanical waves depends on the restoring force and inertial properties for transverse wave. Here it is a longitudinal wave, therefore this longitudinal wave depends on the elastic properties and also on inertial properties. And for every medium, the medium whenever suffers pressure, whenever applied pressure, this medium undergoes change in value. That is nothing but volumetric change. Change in pressure leads to volumetric change, which is nothing but bulk modulus. This bulk modulus B is equal to minus delta V by V. Okay, change in pressure leads to volumetric change, which is nothing but bulk modulus. So here I am going to discuss about every medium. So to find out this speed of a longitudinal wave, I am considering this speed is directly proportional to this bulk modulus and also the inertial properties. Here the inertial property for a medium is the density of the medium, and it is denoted with rho. So this speed is directly proportional to bulk modulus and rho, and here I am taking b power a and rho power b. Okay, same way manam transverse wave ki speed find out chesinatte ikkada kuda same process manam follow avdam. For that purpose I am considering the dimensional formula for the speed and the bulk modulus and the density. So for speed, the dimensional formula is length into t power minus 1. And coming to this bulk modulus, the dimensional formula for bulk modulus is m l power minus 1 t power minus 2. And the dimensional formula for density is, this is a mass per length, which is nothing but m l power minus 1 t power 0. Okay. Now substitute in this equation, this is equation number 1 and these equations are equation number 2. Substitute second all these equations in equation number 1. Okay, this V is nothing but m naught L t power minus 1, which is directly proportional to B power A, that is m L power minus 1 t power minus 2 all power A. And rho power B, this rho is nothing but density, which is m L power minus 1 t power 0 all power B. Okay, now here bases are same. Okay, now you can equate the powers. Sorry, this is volumetric density, therefore here we have L power minus 3. Please correct this equation, L power minus 3. Okay, now for mass I have power A plus B, which is equals to 0. And for length I have minus A minus 3B, which is equal to plus 1. And coming to the time, powers of time, here we have minus 2a plus plus 0 which is equal to minus 1. From this equation, this A is equal to 1 by 2, right? A is equal to 1 by 2. Now, I am just substituting this A equals 1 by 2 in equation number A. Okay, this is equation number A, this is equation number B, this is C. I am just substituting this equation number C in A equation. Okay, this A plus B equals to 0. 1 by 2 plus B is equal to 0, therefore B is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, you just copy this. And, did you copy it? So, from equation 1, this velocity is proportional to b power a, what is a? 1 by 2. And rho power b, what is b? Minus 1 by 2. Which is equal to b power 1 by 2 by rho power 1 by 2. Right? So, since this a power 1 by 2 is nothing but square root of a, I am writing here. I am rewriting this equation as square root of b by rho. Okay, and I want to remove this proportional. Therefore, we have this v is equal to c into square root of b by rho. This c is nothing but 1. The value of this proportionality constant is nothing but 1. Therefore, the velocity of a longitudinal wave in any medium is nothing but square root of b by rho. You just copy this. And we are going to find out the velocity of the longitudinal wave in solids, liquids and in ideal gases. This is equation 1, Roman number get this quantity. Okay, we are going to use this equation further. So, I am going to find out the speed of a longitudinal wave in solids. For solids, the elastic property is the Young's modulus. Here the elastic properties is the Young's modulus. See, about bulk modulus, Young's modulus, we will discuss in the mechanical properties of the fluids chapter. Okay, you just don't worry. In solids, the elastic property of the solid is the bulk modulus, which is denoted with Y. Okay, and from equation 1, V is equal to square root of B by rho. You just simply substitute this bulk modulus. You just substitute this bulk modulus with Young's modulus, Y. Okay. Therefore, this V, speed of this wave is equal to square root of Y by rho. This is the speed of a longitudinal wave in solids. Coming to liquids. Speed of the longitudinal wave in liquids. Coming to liquids, the elastic property of the liquid is nothing but this bulk modulus only. Therefore, the speed of the longitudinal wave in liquid is square root of b by rho. This is in liquids. Okay, and coming to ideal gases. Are you writing in your notes? Just pause the video and copy in your notes. Coming to ideal gases. कमिंग टू द आइडियल गैसेस अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन, लिसन केयरफुली, अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन द आइडियल गैसेस फॉलोज आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस इज नथिंग बट देर इज नो चेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर, द चेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर इज इक्वल टू जीरो. Whenever the particles, whenever the sound wave is propagating in a medium, the particle undergoes compressions and rarefactions. Okay, whenever the wave is propagating, we have two different regions. One is compressed region, the other is rarefaction region. Okay, here as these particles are vibrating about their mean position, the temperature of these regions are increased, but the temperature exchange doesn't takes place. Temperature exchange avvadu, temperature increase ayindi kani temperature exchange avvatle ikkada. Okay na, so here the change of temperature will be equals to zero for isothermal process according to Newton. He considered this isothermal process, and for isothermal process the pressure, temperature and volume of the gas are related as PV equals to NKBT, where P is the pressure and V is the volume of the gas, N is the number of molecules in volume V, and KB is the Boltzmann constant, T is the temperature of the gas. And if you differentiate the above equation, okay, differentiation of x into y will be, first take x outside, then after differentiation of x and y will be, first take x outside, then after differentiate y, plus take y outside and differentiate x, okay, x into y, write this. Differentiate this equation. Now P into delta V, there will be very small change, therefore I have taken here delta, plus V into delta P, which is equals to, as this delta T is equals to 0 and N is a constant, which is a number, therefore it is a constant, the differentiation of constant will be equals to 0, and it is a Boltzmann constant, and here also the differentiation of the constant will be equals to 0, and the change of temperature is equals to 0, that is delta T is equals to 0. If you differentiate this right hand side, you will have 0 on this right hand side. Okay, now P is equals to P into delta V is equals to minus V delta P, and this P is equal to minus V delta P by delta V. Okay, and this equation can be written as delta P by delta V by V, which is nothing but bulk modulus. As we know that the speed of a longitudinal wave is equal to square root of B by rho. Longitudinal wave in a medium, the speed of a longitudinal wave in a medium is square root of B by rho. You just replace this B with P. You have to replace this B with P, and this V is equal to square root of P by rho. According to Newton, the speed of the longitudinal wave in an ideal gas is equal to square root of P by rho. This is P, this is rho. Okay, and if you substitute the pressure of the ideal gas and the density of the ideal gas, the speed is equal to 280 meters per second, which is approximately 15% less, than the measured value. And the measured value is equal to 300 31 meters per second. This is a measured value for the speed of a longitudinal wave. But according to Newton, as per Newton, the speed of the longitudinal wave is square root of p by rho, which is 280 meters per second. It doesn't matches the measured value. Therefore, this equation which was given by the Newton is not correct. And Laplace, a scientist named Laplace, corrected this equation by assuming that ideal gases follows the adiabatic process. Okay, Laplace correction for this Newton's equation. Okay, Laplace correction. He assumed that the ideal gases follows adiabatic process. Coming to the adiabatic process, the change of heat doesn't takes place. Okay, delta Q is equal to 0 for adiabatic process. Copy in your notebook by pausing the video. So for adiabatic process, the ideal gas relation for adiabatic process is PV gamma is constant, where this gamma is equals to Cp by Cv, which is nothing but specific heat gas constant at constant pressure, and specific heat gas constant at constant value. Okay, and if you differentiate above equation, this equation, V power gamma delta P plus P into gamma V power gamma minus 1, which is equals to 0. Differentiation of constant is equals to 0. Now, this P gamma V power gamma minus 1 is equal to minus V power gamma into delta P. Okay. This is a Laplace correction. Keep the heading Laplace correction. And from this equation, the pressure P is equal to minus V gamma delta P by, just bring this towards right side, gamma V power gamma minus 1. Okay. Here P is equal to delta P by gamma into. This V is nothing but, I differentiated this V power gamma. Therefore, here I have delta V. Okay. Here I have delta V. Just correct this equation. Okay. Gamma into V power gamma minus 1 into, I just bring this towards denominator. Therefore, I have minus gamma into delta V. Therefore, this pressure P is equal to delta P by gamma into delta V into minus gamma plus gamma cancels. I have V power minus 1. Okay, I can write this V power minus 1 in denominator. Therefore, by rewriting this equation, this pressure P is equal to delta P by gamma into delta V by V. Delta V by V, right? This delta P, I have minus sign. This delta P minus delta P by delta V by V is nothing but bulk modulus. Just substitute in this equation. Therefore, this P is equal to V by gamma. P is equal to gamma into V. Okay. Just copy this by pausing your video. And we know that the speed of a longitudinal wave in medium is equal to square root of B by rho. You now just replace this bulk modulus with gamma P. Okay. therefore this v is equal to square root of gamma p by rho. This is the corrected equation by Laplace. Okay, this is the Laplace correction for speed of a longitudinal wave, the 2s sound wave. Okay, and this value is approximately equal to 331 meters per second, which is measured value. And for air, this gamma value is equal to 7/5 for air. For air, gamma is 7/5. Using this equation, you can also find out the speed of the air. Sorry, speed of the longitudinal wave in air, which is equal to 7 p/5 rho. This is the speed of the longitudinal wave in air at standard temperature and pressure. This is the speed of the longitudinal wave in air at standard temperature and pressure. Okay, let's end our lecture here itself, and in our next lecture I am going to discuss about superposition principle. Superposition principle, and I need 1k subscribers for doing live lectures, so please share my lectures with your friends. So therefore, whoever need my lectures will subscribe to my channel, and please click on the like button. Okay, bye.